What is asbestos? Asbestos is a mineral fiber that has fire-resistant and insulation properties. And because of this, it was popular for a period of time in home construction. It was an inexpensive material used on pipes and in attics, but also incorporated into many other products such as floor coverings, siding, plaster, roofing, caulking, and glue. Brief history of asbestos. A naturally occurring mineral fiber found in dirt and rocks, asbestos has been around for a long time, dating back to the Stone Age. Archaeologists have found embalmed Egyptian pharaohs wrapped in a cloth made from asbestos. Clay pots in Finland were found to have asbestos fibers embedded in them. However, even then, historians note that the Romans and Greeks were aware that those who worked with this material seemed to have lung problems and other illnesses. In the Middle Ages, asbestos was used in table coverings to minimize the fires that were ignited by the celebrations. For catapults, flaming bags of burning material were wrapped in asbestos before they were launched at the enemy. There's an asbestos purse in London's Natural History Museum, and as the use spread to paper, asbestos became part of Italian banknotes in the 1800s. During the Industrial Revolution, the mining of asbestos took off as the demand increased. It was used in building automobiles, as well as for the military and in construction. When mining became mechanized around the early 1900s, production expanded, prices dropped, and it seemed like asbestos was showing up everywhere. It's even in some of the roads that were built between the 1930s to the 1950s. The application seemed limitless since the material proved to be resistant to not only fire, but water, chemicals, and electricity. Add that it was pliable and cost-effective, and the result is a product that could insulate and strengthen as well as function in many ways. Around the same time asbestos was becoming widespread, reports were coming in about detrimental health effects from working around asbestos and its related products. Lung problems were documented, and as early as 1906, the first death directly attributed to asbestos happened to a 33-year-old in London who died from pulmonary failure. Regardless, asbestos use continued to grow. Even today, asbestos is not a banned material in the United States. But in the 1970s, the federal government did enact legislation to limit the use and application of asbestos. Where asbestos is commonly found. Asbestos can be found in homes in many places. Because it was cheap and readily available, it was incorporated into a variety of products. You can't identify what products contain asbestos by looking at them. It requires knowledge, and if you think asbestos could be a problem, it's a good idea to bring in an expert. Some of the products containing asbestos and found in homes include roofing shingles, siding, floor tiles, wall and attic insulation, wall and ceiling patching materials, water and other pipes, glue and cement compounds. You really need a professional to locate the occurrences of asbestos, because even just testing for the material can disturb it and make it toxic. Why is asbestos dangerous? When microscopic asbestos fibers get into the body, often through the lungs, they cannot be expelled by normal functions. The body is not equipped to rid itself of this toxin. In fact, the tiny fibers can get past the lung's normal filtration system to affect the rest of the body. If the fibers are swallowed, they can cause trouble in the stomach. Some researchers even believe that asbestos can infiltrate the lymphatic system. Whatever way it happens to get into the body, Once it's there, it cannot be removed. Continued exposure to asbestos and the sharp, minuscule particles can burrow into tissues and even change them, resulting in disease. These diseases can take a long time to develop, but they can be deadly. The three most common are asbestosis, a serious, chronic, non-cancer lung disease caused by inhaling asbestos fibers. The symptoms can be mild to severe and generally don't appear for many years after exposure, with some cases showing up 40 years later. Mesothelioma, an aggressive, rare form of cancer that affects the lining of the lungs, pleural mesothelioma, or the stomach, peritoneal mesothelioma. Diagnosis can be complicated, and it's often diagnosed in the later stages. Mesothelioma usually has a poor prognosis with no known cure. And lung cancer. Lung cancer and mesothelioma are both caused by asbestos, and they cause similar symptoms. The difference is where they originate. Lung cancer begins in the lungs, while mesothelioma is in the lining of the lungs. The treatment is different in each case, as is the prognosis. Since asbestos is still being used in some materials today, despite the fact that it's so toxic, you might be wondering why. The answer lies in the condition of the asbestos, which is either friable or non-friable. Friable asbestos is that which can be crumbled or made into a powder. Non-friable asbestos is in a whole state and is not usually dangerous until it's cut, sawed, or sanded, at which point it becomes the powder that can be a health hazard. It's important to note that the buyer, agent, homeowner, or any untrained person should never try to remove or sample suspected asbestos. The mere disturbance of the material can release the dangerous elements. The nature of home construction and remodeling is that it's very likely any asbestos or asbestos-related materials will be cut, sawed, or sanded, creating an unsafe situation. Even normal living wear and tear can disrupt the condition of the asbestos, so it's important to monitor it even if it appears to be fine at the moment. Mitigating asbestos might mean removing the material, but sometimes the threat can be contained with less drastic measures. Again, it depends on the circumstances. If the asbestos needs to be removed, it should be done by a contractor who is certified to do abatement work. Special precautions need to be taken when the inevitable fibers become airborne. The use of disposable protective clothing, HEPA filters, and other containment precautions are recommended. How does asbestos affect the buying and selling of a home? Let's say after months of searching, the buyers have found a delightful older home at a price they can afford and in the location they want. It's exactly what they've been looking for, and they are excited beyond belief. They open escrow and order a home inspection. The inspector identifies two areas of concern and recommends they have an asbestos abatement specialist come in, test the materials, and suggest how the issues might be resolved. One of the rooms has been remodeled and now has a popcorn ceiling, sometimes called a cottage cheese or stucco ceiling. Since not all popcorn ceilings are made of asbestos, the buyers agree to get an expert's opinion. The expert, a professional in abatement, knows that asbestos popcorn ceilings were banned by the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, in 1977, but didn't have information on when the room had been remodeled, so he carefully took a sample, making sure not to release the harmful fibers. In another area of the house, the professional found some pipe insulation that was made from asbestos, and he didn't feel it was safe to leave it as is. The news is upsetting to the buyers, and their first questions are about their options. As with most issues in a real estate purchase, they have choices. Here, there are basically three options. They can 1. Continue with the sales process, accepting the report results. 2. Stop the purchasing process and cancel the contract. This choice can have financial repercussions depending on the terms of the contract. And 3. Negotiate with the seller. Usually this step involves getting estimates for remediation, then working with the seller to come to an agreement that suits both parties. In this scenario, the buyers loved the home and they had already spent a lot of time looking at properties that didn't fit their needs. The professional suggested removing the ceiling popcorn after it tested positive for asbestos, and simply containing the questionable pipe insulation so the asbestos would be sealed in and unable to contaminate anything. Since the problems and solutions were reasonable, the sellers agreed to pay the cost of this work, and the sale was back on track and headed for closing. The key is for all parties to be informed, aware of the methods to correct the situation, and willing to work together to find a solution. In homes built before 1980, asbestos was commonly used because the dangers were not known. Since that time, with the dangers revealed, it's important to inform property owners and buyers about the use or suspected use of the product. But it doesn't have to mean the deal is automatically off, because there have been a variety of ways invented to remedy the situation, out of necessity, since this problem still comes up frequently in older homes. If the buyer and the seller want to complete the sale, it's vital for you, as the agent, to explore ways to make that happen. That will ensure the safety and satisfaction of all involved. Your ability to help the parties navigate circumstances like these will result in a wonderful reputation as a professional and solution-oriented agent.